Once upon a time, what changed when the Indian tectonic plate bumped into the Eurasian plate? Uniuronic plate tectonic. Earth's outer shell is divided into large slabs of solid rock called plates that make up continents. These plates glide over Earth's mantle due to the heat currents building up deep inside the Earth's core. This geological theory called plate tectonic theory includes the movement of plates like the Eurasian plate and the Indian plate, among others. La La Land, Gondwanaland. Millennia ago, the supercontinent of Gondwanaland was formed with present-day South America, Africa, India, Australia and Antarctica. About 180 million years ago, it began to break up with the Indian subcontinent drifting northwards at about 10 cm per year. Covering a whopping 9,000 km in 70 million years, it's eventually hit the Eurasian plate. And voila, the Himalayas. As India crashed into the Eurasian plate, it gave rise to the highest mountain range of the world, the Himalayas. The mighty rivers of the Ganges, the Indus, the Yangtze, and the Brahmaputra originated in the Himalayas. The sediment from the eroding Himalayan rocks led to the formation of the Bengal Delta. The Viking funeral ship. One of the alleged Viking traditions called for dead Vikings to be set off to the seas in a funeral ship along with their belongings. Interestingly, India's journey across the waters carrying along the animal and plant biology from erstwhile Gondwanaland makes it comparable to the Viking funeral ship. Notably, fossils of the same extinct species were found in both India and Africa. Boiling pot for biological evolution. As India was getting closer to the Eurasian plate over millions of years, withstanding several climatic changes, evolution took the front seat. A deer-like mammal, Indohyus, once living on the Indian subcontinent, is said to have evolved into what we know today as the whale. Hakuna Matata. Before the collision of the Indian and Eurasian plates, the earth was so warm that there were no ice caps on the north and south poles. Silicates in the Himalayas started to quickly absorb large amounts of CO2 from the atmosphere, resulting in global cooling. Thus began the last ice age. Is India still moving? The answer is yes. What is the proof? Well, the Bhuj Gujarat earthquake in 2001 and the Nepal earthquake in 2015. Although slowed down, the Indian subcontinent continues to move northwards, resulting in phenomena such as earthquakes.